Good morning, Ganesh. In the last class, we have discussed about the characteristics of the SCR. So, forward conduction mode and reverse leakage current and forward blacking mode, reverse blacking mode and all we have discussed in the last class. And of course, we have discussed about latching current and holding current also. Here, this is the diagram. I think in the last video, that diagram is not clear, but here, this is the diagram you can consider. And so, coming to the next one is thyristor turn on methods. That means here, in order to turn on the thyristor, there will be all the some methods are there. What are those means? Forward voltage triggering and gate triggering and dv by dt triggering and temperature triggering and light triggering. So coming to the first one. First one is forward voltage triggering. Forward voltage triggering. Whenever you are going for the forward voltage triggering, what is the process means? Suppose if there are a if there are the junctions, okay, if there are the junctions J1 and J2 and J3, okay, so whenever your forward voltage has been applied between the anode to cathode with the gate circuit open, then automatically this J2 has been reverse biased, okay, this J2 has been reverse biased, then as a result the depletion layer is formed across the junction J2. That means the width of this layer is decreasing with an increasing the anode to cathode voltage. If the forward voltage across the anode to cathode is gradually increased, a stage will come when the depletion layer across the J2 vanishes. That means at that moment, the reverse biased junction J2 is said to be under avalanche breakdown. Okay, avalanche breakdown. The voltage at which it occurs is called as the forward breakover voltage. It is represented by VBO. That means here the name forward breakover voltage is given because at this voltage VBO, the characteristics breaks over and shifts to its on state position with breakover current IBO. At this voltage, thyristor changes from off state to on state, which is characterized by low voltage across the thyristor with a large forward current. That means here, as already forward junctions are forward biased, that means J1, J3 are forward biased, breakdown of the junction J2 allows the free movement of the carriers. Okay, breakdown of the J2 will allow the free movement of the carriers across the junctions. And as a result, large forward anode current will be flowing. So, therefore, forward current is limited. And next, here, after the avalanche breakdown, the junction J2 losses its reverse blacking capability. Therefore, if the anode voltage is reduced to below the VBO, SCR will continue conduction of the current. The SCR can now be turned off by only reducing the anode current below a certain value called holding current, which I have already we have discussed. So ultimately here in this we need to discuss is, so simply J2 is going for the reverse bias. As J2 is going for the reverse bias, then if you increase the forward voltage, okay, if you increase the forward voltage, then automatically it will get avalanche breakdown, and that voltage can be called as a forward breakover voltage. After that, you can reduce somewhat level, and below that level you can operate your SCR, so it means for conduction state. So in this way, the this forward voltage method, that means as you are gradually increased, okay, as you are gradually increased, there will be a breakdown will be occurring. So this is the forward voltage triggering explanation. This explanation will be applicable for all the triggering. So next triggering is gate triggering. Coming to gate triggering, this is the most simple, okay, this is the most simple and of course reliable and efficient also. So it is therefore it will be used for the basically usual method for firing the forward biased SCRs. And next, here also higher the gate current, okay, higher the gate current and lower the forward breakover voltage, okay, higher the gate current, lower the forward breakover voltage. That means whenever the positive gate current is applied, okay, whenever the positive gate current is applied, what is happening? The gate P layer is flooded with electrons from the cathode. And if the magnitude of the gate current is increased, okay, if the magnitude of the gate current is increased, more electrons would reach the junction J2. So that's why our thyristor will be turning on. And next, here one more thing you need to remember. Here typical gate current magnitudes are of the 20 to the 200 milliamperes. So please remember this point. 20 to the 200 milliamperes is the gate current. And of course, latching current, already you know, latching current may be defined as the minimum value of the anode current which it must attain during the turn on process to maintain the conduction when the gate signal is removed. And what about the holding current? Holding current is coming under turn off process. Holding current means may be defined as the minimum value of the anode current below which it must fall for turn off of the thyristor. And next one is dV by dt triggering. Coming to dV by dt triggering, whenever forward voltage has been applied, J1 and J3 will be forward biased, but J2 is reverse biased. So at that time, what is nothing but the characteristics of a capacitor due to charges existing across this junction. So in other words, the space charges exist in the depletion region near the junction J2. Therefore, junction J2 behaves like a capacitance. If the forward voltage is suddenly applied, okay, if the forward voltage is suddenly applied, a charging current is across through the junction capacitance may be formed, and next charging current will be there. IC is equal to dq divided by dt. Here simply by applying q, substituting d by dt of what is the junction capacitance Cj, and next voltage is appeared is Va, that is the forward voltage applied. By means of this one, what you can get Cj into dVa divided by dt plus Va into dCj divided by dt. So it is the constant. In general, the capacitance, junction capacitance will be almost constant. So that's why it will be is equal to 0. So finally, IC is equal to Cj into dVa divided by dt. We can get that means what is mean by this one means. Okay, what is mean by this one means, as if the rate of rise of forward voltage is high, the charging current IC would be more. That means here this charging current plays the vital role of the gate current and turns on the SCR even though gate signal is zero. And next one is the temperature triggering. What is the temperature triggering? Just like the same case here also, as the temperature, okay, with the increase in the temperature, what is happening? Width of the depletion layer, okay, width of the depletion layer will be decreases. This further leads to the more leakage current, okay, this further leads to the more leakage current, and therefore more junction temperature also. So with the cumulative process at some high temperatures, depletion layer of the reverse bias junction vanishes and the device gets turned on. Okay, please remember this one. And the next one is light triggering. What is the light triggering? Here light means here laser light, they will use LASCR. Thus remaining process would be same. That means laser light LASCR may be triggered with a light source or with gate signal. That means by means of this one here we will start our ACR. These are the methods. Okay, and of course this light triggered thyristors may be useful in HVDC, high voltage DC transmission systems we will use. So these are the triggering methods of the, okay, these are the different triggering turning on of the our thyristor. Next concept is characteristics during the turn on and turn off. So what are those characteristics we will see now. So first one is here, whenever you are going for this turning on and turning off of the characteristics. So here, what is my turn on? Turn on means SCR turn on time. Okay, SCR turn on time means here SCR turn on time. Okay, SCR turn on time. SCR turn on time is equal to the, what is my that one? The time during which SCR changes from the forward blacking mode. Okay, forward blacking mode to the final on state. Final on state can be called as the SCR turn on time. What is the total turn on time? And this total turn on time can be divided into three parts, which is nothing but डिले टाइम टी डी प्लस राइज टाइम टी आर प्लस पीक टाइम टी पी. दैट मीन्स हियर दिस टोटल टाइम कैन बी डिवाइडेड इनटू थ्री पार्ट्स. डिले टाइम विच इज डिपेंडेड बाय टी डी एंड राइज टाइम टी आर एंड नेक्स्ट पीक स्प्रेड टाइम. ओके स्प्रेड टाइम विच इज डिपेंडेड बाय टी पी. So in this one, what is the definitions of the our delay time, rise time, peak time? We will see now. First, we will see the definitions, and after that one, we will go with respect to the our waveform. That means with respect to the characteristics. First one is delay time. Okay, first one is delay time. Here it is represented by TD. What is by delay time? This is the time between the instant at which the gate current reaches 0.9 times of the IG to the instant at which the anode current reaches to the 0.1 times of the IA, where IG and IA are respectively the final values of the gate and anode currents. And next, what is the one more definition with respect to the voltage? It may be also defined in another way, that the time during which the anode voltage falls from VA to 0.9 times of the VA can be called as a delay time. And one more definition you can get with respect to the leakage current, which is nothing but the time during which the anode current rises from the forward leakage current, okay, forward leakage current to the 0.1 times of the IA, where IA is the final value of the anode current. These are the basic definitions of the our respective delay time. And next one is rise time. Okay, rise time is represented by simply TR. What is by this one? The time taken by the anode current to rise from the 0.1 times of the IA to 0.9 times of the IA is known as the rise time. And next, this rise time is also defined as the time required by the forward blocking voltage to fall from the 0.9 to 0.1 of its initial value. That means here, whatever may be the ending point of the our delay time 0.1 IA, that is the starting point for the rise time, and whatever may be the ending point of the delay time with respect to voltage, that will be the starting point for the our rise time with respect to voltage. And next, coming to spread time. Spread time is represented by TP, which is nothing but the time taken by the anode current to rise from the 0.9 times of the IA to IA is known as the spread time, or otherwise in another verse in which way we can define, means it is the time for the forward blocking voltage. Okay, it is the time for the forward blocking voltage to fall from the 0.1 of its initial value to the on state voltage drop. Okay, on state voltage drop is known as the spread time. And the next one is here, these are the times. Okay, these are the times with respect to the turning on. That means the turning on is divided into TD, TR, TP. And with next, with respect to the turn off also. Okay, with respect to the turn off also, there will be some definitions are there. So we will see now. So here, SCR turn off means it is changing from the on state to the off state and is capable of blocking the forward voltage. What is mean by turn off process or commutation process? You need to remember, commutation process or turn off process. So it means the dynamic process of the SCR from conduction state to the forward blocking state, conduction state to the forward blocking state, is called commutation process or turn off process. So please remember this one. And next, turn off time. Okay, turn off time is represented by simply TQ. Okay, what is by turn off time here? The time between the instant anode current becomes zero, anode current becomes zero, and the instant SCR regains its forward blocking capability. During this time, all the excess carriers from the four layers of the SCR are removed. So this turn off time also will be divided into two parts. DQ is divided into two parts. First one is reverse recovery time TRR plus gate recovery time TGR. Here, what is mean by reverse recovery time means here, the reverse recovery time is nothing but the time between the the time between the anode current becomes zero. Okay, anode current becomes zero and up to the recombination occurs is called as the our T or a. And after that, from recombination stage to the our voltage is becoming zero, then up to that point can be called as the TGR, which is nothing but gate recovery time. This total time can be called as the turn off time. And one more definition here you can remember, total, that one is circuit turn off time. Okay, circuit turn off time is represented by TC, which is nothing but, what is meant by circuit turn off time? It is defined as the time between the instant anode current becomes zero and the instant reverse voltage due to practical circuit, reverse voltage due to practical circuit is approaches to zero. So this is nothing but turn off, circuit turn off time. Here CTC is nothing but circuit turn off time. Okay, circuit turn off time. But whereas TQ is equal to the thyristor turn off time. Please remember these two differences. So these are the general general definitions with respect to without our graph. Suppose if we are seeing the graph, okay, if we are seeing the graph, what are the these definitions will be, we will see now. So here you can observe in the diagram, here the voltage VA is there, and next one is anode voltage and gate current, and next one is anode current, and next one is power loss you can observe. So from the first diagram, okay, from the first diagram, from the first diagram he has given the gate ones, so automatically your SCR is going to be turned on. So at the time, what is the, what are the time you need to get? Delay time, rise time, and spread time. So all these times you can get at the turn on time. So delay time, what is meant by delay time? The time between the instant at which gate current reaches 0.9 times of the IG to the instant at which the anode current reaches 0.1 times of the IA. That means here the delay time, the what is my delay time? Gate current reaches to the 0.9 times of the IG. Here this is the point, 0.9 times of the IG to the instant at which anode current reaches to the 0.1 times of the IA. Here this is the 0.1 times of the IA. That means here by corresponding this point will be here. So here this is the point. Between these two points, here this is the one point, and then here this is the one point, which is nothing but gate current is reaching 0.9 times of the IG, and next anode current reaches to the 0.1 times of the IA. Between these two points, there is a time is there. That time is called delay time with respect to this span. And next definition, according to the next, with respect to the voltage, what is the definition delay time? Delay time may also be defined as the time during which anode voltage falls from VA to the 0.9 times of the VA. Where this is the VA? Here you can observe that VA, and here this is the 0.9 times of the VA. Here you can observe between these two points, okay, between these two points by means of the dotted mark, here you can observe this is the delay time, which is nothing but the time during which the anode voltage falls from the VA to 0.9 times of the VA is called delay time. Next one, Andy. That one more definition. What is the definition? The time during which anode current rises from the forward leakage current to, okay, forward leakage current is here. You can observe forward leakage current to 0.1 times of the IA. 0.1 forward leakage current to 0.1 times of the IA is this point. Up to that point is called the delay time. That means whatever may be the time taking now, and current rises from the forward leakage current. Here you can observe forward leakage current point is this one, and 0.1 times of the IA is this one. So between these two points you can observe the delay time. This is the, these are the basic definitions of the our delay time. And next one, rise time. What is by rise time? The time taken by the anode current to rise from the 0.1 times of the IA to the 0.9 times of the IA. Here 0.1 times of the IA, okay, 0.1 times of the IA is here, and next 0.9 times of the IA is here. Between these two points, okay, between these two points the time will be taken, that can be represented by our rise time. And next one is the rise time may also be defined as the time required for the forward blocking of state voltage to fall from the 0.9 to the 0.1 of its initial value. That means with respect to the voltage, in which way? Here this is the one point, okay, here from the 0.9 of the VA to the find one of its initial value can be taken as the our rise time. Okay, our rise time. Yes, this is the rise time. And next definition is spread time. The time taken by the anode current to rise from the 0.9 times of the IA to the IA. Read that one. 0.9 times of the IA is here and IA is here. Between these two points, you can observe one point. That is nothing but your spread time. And it is also defined as the in which way, in the another way you can define as the time for the forward backing voltage to fall from the 0.1 of its VA to the initial value, 0.1 of its initial value to the on state voltage drop. Here, this is the on state voltage drop now. Between these two points, okay, between these two points, there is a time that is nothing but your spread time. Yeah, that is the spread time. So these are the basic definitions of the turn on time, so delay time, rise time, spread time with respect to the turn on. And next, what is the turn off time? Turn off time is equal to, okay, turn off time is equal to, there is a turn off time is nothing but time between the instant anode current becomes zero. Okay, anode current becomes zero. Here, this is the anode current is becoming zero. And the instant SCR regains its blacking capability. Okay, its blacking capability, it is gaining here. Up to this point can be called as the turn off time. And of course, this turn off time can be divided into two parts. One is TRR and TGR. TRR is nothing but reverse recovery time. Reverse recovery time means here, between the current is zero and up to recombination occur, up to this point, the reverse recovery time will be there. Here you can observe, this will be the called as the reverse recovery time. And next one is the gate recovery time. Gate recovery time means from this point to up to this point. Okay, from this point, from the recombination point to where recombination starting point to our power voltage is becoming zero now. Up to that means that property, that value can be called as the our gate recovery time. And if you consider the total, okay, the total, that means when the circuit turn off time. Circuit turn off means the time between the instant anode current becomes zero and where the instant reverse voltage due to practical circuit reaches to zero. Reaches to zero means here you can observe at this point it is becoming zero now. So up to that point is called reverse voltage due to power circuit is becoming zero up to this point. This point can be called as the circuit turn off time you can observe. So these are the characteristics, these are the times with respect to the turn off time. So here that means in the turn on time you can get a delay time, rise time, peak time. In the turn off time you can get a reverse recovery time and gate recovery time and circuit turn off time. Here one more point you need to remember, always your circuit turn off time TC is always greater than the TP. Please remember this one. And next here, the thyristor slow with a slow turn off time. Okay, thyristor with a slow turn off time. Slow turn off time undi ankonde. Okay, now if the thyristor turn off time is slow, then they can be called as a converter grade SCR. Please remember that converter grade SCR. Thyristor with a slow turn off time, converter grade SCR. Thyristor with a fast turn off time. Okay, thyristor with a fast turn off time can be called as the inverter grade SCR. And thyristors with a slow turn off time. Okay, thyristors with a slow turn off time. Here I will say thyristor with a slow turn off time. Thyristor with a slow turn off time. Turn off time called as a converter grade SCR. What are the examples here? Phase controlled rectifiers and cyclo converters and AC voltage controllers are known examples for the slow turn off time. And SCR with a fast turn off time. SCR with a fast turn off time called as the inverter grade SCR. Which are nothing but examples. What are the examples here? Inverters and choppers and forced commutation converters are examples for the our inverter grade SCR. Here, this is the class for today. Thank you.